Hi, welcome to my channel.
Here is a full review of the all-new 2021 OMEN 17 from HP. HP redesigned almost everything from previous model. Is it better? Let's take a look. I will cover all the topics listed here. You can jump to any timeline from the descriptions below. Here is the configuration of this laptop. This is the first Intel 10nm processor on gaming platform. This year, Intel upgraded not only the process, but also the CPU architecture with the new name Tiger Lake. Let's see how much improvement we can get. The GPU is a full-power RTX 3070 with a dynamic boost to 140 watts. We will see if the cooling system can handle this plus 200 watts combination. This new OMEN 17 also has a significant upgrade to the screen and the keyboard, which makes this gaming laptop a great choice for content creator as well. The first impression of this screen is big, white, and comfortable. This panel reaches a great balance between the daily use, gaming, and content creation. The test results confirm that this is a great panel. The color gamma is 98% of sRGB with a good tone response. The brightness is also great with a 370 nits. The uniform of this screen looks okay, I didn't feel any uncomfortable. The color accuracy of this screen is excellent. The average delta is only 1.6. Overall, I like this screen very much. It will be great if this screen can support G-Sync next year. This year, the new OMEN 17 has an optional configuration of a mechanical keyboard. Based on my experience, I have three thoughts of these new keyboards. Firstly, it has a good click sound. The typing experience is likely a shorter version of the Cherry Blue Switch. Secondly, as I mentioned in my last open box video, I still don't like the keyboard layout. HP has a column of function keys on the left and move all the keys one unit right, but they still keep the trackpad at the center. This will make whenever you use the trackpad to locate your hands, it is very easy to get typos, since all keys are moved one unit to the right compared to your muscle memory on a normal keyboard. It will take you some time to get used to it every time you switch over to this keyboard. Thirdly, I like this RGB light. You can switch between multiple modes in the HP Command Center. Overall, it's a good keyboard, but I personally want to have a better layout. I already reviewed the I/O ports in my last open box video. The only thing I want to add on is that the Thunderbolt port can transfer data at around 800 megabits per second with my USB-C 3.2 SSD. Thanks to the HDMI 2.1 port, this laptop can export up to 8K video through that port. The weight for this 17-inch laptop is pretty acceptable, but as I mentioned before, it doesn't support a PD charger, so the huge adapter is a troublemaker. Based on my observation, this 330W adapter is much overkilled for this i7 plus 3070 combination. If HP can provide a 250W gallium nitride adapter, like what Dell did for their X series, that would make this machine an excellent choice for more people. For the size, here is a comparison to the recent most popular gaming laptop, Legend 5 Pro. The OMEN 17 has a longer length but shorter width, and it is slightly thicker compared with the Legend 5 Pro. It's time to switch the gear to the performance test. The BIOS and the drivers are all latest versions so far. You can find how to change the HP command control in my last open box video. I'm using the Cinebench R23 for the CPU test. The multiport performance can hit around 14,000 with the power 96 watts. I continually ran 3 times. The score can maintain a similar number. I didn't see a temperature threshold. The single core can hit around 1500. Overall, the CPU performance is pretty impressive. The multi-core performance is around 25% higher compared with the 10th-gen i7 processor. Benefit from a higher operating frequency, the single core also improved around 20%. 3D Mark Time Spy can test the GPU performance. This OMEN 17 scored around 11,000, which is in the tier 1 of laptop RTX 3070. Benefit from the Intel 11th Gen processor, the SSD is upgraded to PCIe 4.0. The benchmark result is pretty good,
But this result is tested at the SSD usage of 1/3 of the total capacity. The score will degrade when you use more space of the SSD. I totally test 4 games both in 2K and 1080p resolution. You can find the frame rate, temperature level, noise level in each of the scenario in this video. The frame rate results of 2K and 1080p are pretty similar for Dota 2. During the heavy team fight, both of the two scenarios will get around average 130fps. The only differences come from the GPU usage. The 2K resolution used around 20% more GPU compared with the 1080p. The fan noise is noticeable lower for the 1080p resolution. The GPU side is 3 degrees cooler for the 1080p resolution. For Battlefield 5, the frame rate will boost around 40fps in the 1080p resolution. This will be a trade-off between the frame rate and the resolution. The noise for both of the resolution are super loud. Even though the fan noise is loud, the cooling results are super good. For RDR2, the frame rate gap between the 2K and the 1080p are much smaller, and the noise level are almost identical. The laptop can maintain a comfortable temperature, but trade off with the noise level. Cyberpunk is the most challenged game I have tested. The frame rate of the 2K resolution dropped below 60fps even with the DLS on, but I still recommend you to use the 2K resolution. It is really a great experience to play this game on this wonderful screen. To my surprise, the fan noise is not super high, but the temperature level is slightly higher compared with other games. As I mentioned before, this laptop is not only good at gaming, but also a great choice for content creator. The benchmark for the Adobe PR is tested both at hybrid and discrete graphic cards mode. The discrete GPU mode scored 50 higher compared with the hybrid mode. But if you compare the sub-item standard export score, the hybrid mode actually can give you a better number. That's because the new PR version supports the integrated GPU and external GPU working together to boost the exporting speed.
SpecWheelPerf is a benchmark test of the performance of industry creative software like Maya and Solidworks. It simulated the performance like 3D modeling and 3D animation. Compared the score with the database in the software website, this result is pretty impressive. This OMEN 17 can rank at the first tier of the laptop 3070 graphic cards. Compared the results between the two GPU modes, the discrete mode can be a much better choice.
This laptop can have a 61 hash rate with this overclock setting. You can further lower the GPU voltage to increase the power efficiency. This hash rate is already identical to the desktop 3070. Similar with the gaming experience, the temperature is good, but the fan noise is loud.
From my last teardown video, we found this laptop is equipped with two speakers. Let's have a try the sound quality. This new OMEN 17 has a good design of the motherboard layout. Compared with the previous model, the fan size is increased and the number of the fan fins also increased. These changes make this laptop has a very powerful cooling system, but trade-off is the fan noise. Benefit from the Intel 11th Gen CPU, these two SSD slots are both supporting up to PCIe 4.0. HP prepared both of the holder and the thermal pad for the second SSD. Dell, you should learn from this. It's time to have a summary of this laptop. Obviously, the redesign of this OMEN 17 is successful. A much powerful cooling system makes this laptop having a very good performance during the heavy load tasks. Based on my personal using experience, I made a summary table for this OMEN 17. Benefit from the new Intel 11th Gen processor. It is one of the most CPU powerful laptops in the consumer market now. The full power 3070 GPU also ranking in the top tier of the laptop RTX 3070. The screen did an excellent job both in gaming and content creation. It will be full score if the screen can support the G-Sync.
The PCIe 4.0 SSD has an improvement of the speed, but it is not noticeable in daily use. The default memory is single rank with 16 banks, which is a weakness of this machine. You might need to upgrade that for better gaming FPS. A laptop always have a trade-off between the noise and the thermal. Obviously, this Open 17 choose the thermal over noise, but it doesn't equip any fancy technology like a liquid metal or vapor chamber. It just makes the fan stronger. Even you can hear the fan noise in idle mode in a quiet room. The result shows this machine doesn't have any thermal issue in gaming, content creating, or even mining. The trade-off will be the noise level. Overall, this is a good laptop for extreme performance in this price range, but you need to tolerance the travel weight and fan noise. Thanks for watching, hope you can like this video. See you next time.